Listen, never mind that wedding. We have Hollywood royalty for you tonight. Oscar-winning actress Reese Witherspoon is here! Yeah. Sexiest vampire ever, Robert Pattinson is here! Comedian Chappie Cassandy is here! And Dr. House himself, the fabulous Hugh Laurie is here!
Good, yeah.
Now, Robin and Reese are here to talk about their new film. Yeah, all right. Water for Elephants. Yeah. Mm-hmm. They love elephants. They love them. Yeah. It's all set in a circus. I tell you, I love circuses. You know, the clowns, jugglers, bearded lady. Robert, of course, most famous for playing Edward Cullen in the Twilight film. Yeah, I know, I know. Very popular with us young people. We love it. Yeah. Mm. Of course, traditionally, vampires like to suck the blood of a virgin. Fuller than I thought, you know. I thought I was hungry and, okay, I'm fine. Sometimes I just forget to eat. I do, yeah. Reese, of course, won an Oscar for her role in Walk the Line. And, yes. I'm loving our whoopee audience. And played the ditzy lawyer in Legally Blonde. Yeah, why not? I tell you, America's fantastic, isn't it? There, a vacuous blonde can end up in Harvard. In Britain, they end up here. Not so much a law degree, more an NVQ in vajazzling. Yeah. Also delighted to see Hugh Laurie on the show. How exciting is that? Hugh, of course, plays the genius maverick doctor in House. And I'm not sure how much longer Hugh will carry on the role, but in case he wants to move on, there is an actor who's currently available and has an encyclopedic knowledge of drugs. Yeah. Hey, let's get some guests on! Later on, Hugh Laurie will be joining us, but first, Chappie Days are here again, it's Chappie Cassandy! Beautiful! Let me greet you!
Hello, darling! Nuts!
Sit yourself down! He's the highlight of Twilight, it's Robert Pattinson! Somebody die. It's stylish. It's a very stylish couch. Very stylish.
We didn't phone each other beforehand to check. We usually do. You know, Reese, Robert, and I don't know what happened today.
Welcome all. Now, you two, thank you so much for doing this. I know you've just come from the premiere. How did it go?
It was great. There were a lot of people there.
It's insane, especially at Westfield Shopping Centre as well. It's like, why is this happening here? It
doesn't ooze glamour.
It seems really good. We went in the entrance, like, where all the dumpsters are and stuff. It's great. We always see the glamorous sides of buildings.
And I believe, kind of royal wedding style-y, people had been sleeping there overnight.
Did you? People sleeping out for the royal wedding?
Yes, and your premiere as well. Yeah. Yeah. Water for Elephant style-y, they slept out for the royal wedding. Did you not know that?
Yeah, I didn't know it until we actually got there and people said, I've been here for 32 hours. I know, it was really sweet.
Because some people went to the premiere and now are here.
Oh, hi.
How did they do that?
I remember you were there. You look super familiar.
Reese, that's why you won the Oscar. That was very good. Now, just a week too late for our lovely royal, because you were gutted. You wanted to go to that royal wedding, didn't you?
Yeah, I was a little bit hurt. I was a little hurt I was invited, I'm not going to lie. Because I invited her to my wedding, It's usually, like, in America, we reciprocate. That's how we work.
It's rude. Just rude.
It's rude.
Yes.
No, it's fine.
And the royal family have been good to you, Robert, because didn't... when you went to America?
Oh, God, yeah. I was like, what happened? Have I forgotten something which the royals have done?
I went out with Kate Middleton. I forgot. Yeah.
Yeah, no, I mean, just when I first came, it was very easy to convince people that you're a member of the royal family. Well, at least you kind of know people the first time you go out to LA. Like, you know, because I hadn't worked for 3 years. I was unemployed in London. And then they're like, so what have you been doing for the last 3 years? Like, oh, I've been at RADA with Prince William. Like, oh, that sounds wonderful. You're English. Like, I completely believe you.
That didn't work for me in LA. They bought it when I said I was related to the Al-Fayeds, but not...
But you were practically at Charles and Diana's wedding, weren't you?
I was practically at their wedding. Thank you for bringing that up.
Yeah.
I was 8, and it was a young girl that looked a bit like you, Rhys. We did a whole reenaction of the wedding, and there was a little girl called Tanya Galbraith, and she was Diana. And I wanted to be Diana, but they wouldn't let me be Diana, and I was a horse. I was the horse in the horse-drawn carriage, and because it was primary school and they got really excited, it was an old pantomime horse, and I was the arse end. I fancy reenacting this wedding again and being a horse again, but the front end, and would you be the other bit?
She's being tenacious. Nice. Now, it is such a bizarre coincidence that Rhys and Robert are on the show together. Because, as luck would have it, you're in a film together as well. Water for Elephants. It's out now. It's in cinemas at the moment. And very pleasingly, unlike some films like 12 Monkeys or Swimming with Sharks... Well, you know, you go to see a movie called 12 Monkeys, I wanted monkeys. Oh, yeah. Listen, it's Water for Elephants, you get an elephant. It's good. But you also get, it is, and a lot of people here have seen it already. They've been to see it, yeah.
It's incredibly crazy. Everyone at the premiere had already seen it.
There's a man selling DVDs outside.
But no, but it's a tell us a bit about the story, because it's a really kind of lush, old-fashioned epic romance, isn't it?
Yes, absolutely. It's a movie set in the 1930s circus, and it's got a lot of romance, and it's got a lot of action, and a lot of wild animals.
Will there be a trilogy? Is it like one of those where the next one might be like Whiskey for Walruses?
When I first read the title, I thought it was, do you know that movie like Water for Chocolate? I thought it was the sequel to that.
How much chocolate did she eat?
Water for Elephants. Whoa, that hasn't gone well.
We've got a clip, and as luck would have it, it's the two of you meeting the elephant.
My name is Jacob Jankowski.
How do you do?
And this is... This is Marlena Rosenblum. Ah, you're a beauty. Your skin's a little dry. Maybe you should take care of that. The first thing you notice about a woman's age is her skin.
Oh, great. Just what we need around here, another lush.
Well, you're welcome. Oh. Is this the way elephants flirt?
Would you two like to be alone?
It's extraordinary. And Robert, in an interview, you said something really lovely. You said, and I quote, "She was the best actor I've ever worked with in my life."
I continuously say the wrong thing in interviews. So and it comes back to haunt me afterwards, especially when I'm sitting next to the other best actor I've ever worked with.
Yes, he was referring to Ty the Elephant. But that trunk, the trunk looked quite frisky in that scene with you.
I was trying, because we had to... I think she was just supposed to be sniffing my crotch, I think. But like, and I couldn't get it. And then that was in the book and stuff, but I couldn't really... It's incredibly awkward if you're trying to do the scene, you're like holding her trunk down. And so I put all these jelly beans around so she'd be sniffing around, but I put too many there and then she'd just be, the trunk was all over the place and it was almost impossible to, the scene made no sense. Just like, she kept slapping me in the face.
But you thought you had a special bond with Ty the Elephant, didn't you? You were quite jealous when you saw her with other people.
Yeah, kind of. I genuinely thought that, you know, I thought we had a bond, thought we had a little thing going on.
Have you kept in touch?
Yeah.